Today's ASAP archive video, recorded with Coach Mickey Marotti at the University of Florida's Ben Hill Griffin Stadium, is brought to you by TRX Suspension Training. Reach out to the TRX Collegiate and Professional Team Sports Director, Tim Bork. Also brought to you by the Bill Jacobs Power Company. Build your facility from the ground up. And yes, he's the band man. The Bill Jacobs Power Company. Get everything you need from Coach Jake at CoachBillJacobs.com.
Big Ed! How you doing, Ed? Well, we just got to the stadium. Our players are getting dressed right now. We'll have a group come out and do our dynamic warm-up while some of the other players are in the locker room, in the training room, kind of getting ready. And then we'll bring them out in waves. Our kickers and punters and specialists will come out. And then our quarterbacks and centers, then our wideouts specialist, and then we'll go back in and come out as a team. Pre-game meal, we eat pre-game meal 4 hours before game time, so we ate it at 3 o'clock today. We had carrots and green beans, your choice of rice, sweet potatoes, pasta, and you could add meat sauce or marinara sauce. We had boneless chicken breast and Rice Krispie treats for our high sugar replacement. The Gator Walk is a tradition that Coach Meyer brought here to the University of Florida back in 2005. It's when our players dressed in dress A, which are a shirt tie, get dropped off over in front of the north end zone, and we walk through the crowd. And it's a chance where the fans, parents, friends of Gator Nation can get an up-close look at our players. Our players do a great job of shaking hands, and hugging people, and high fives, and all that sort of stuff. Now, it's an unbelievable opportunity. It's an unbelievable experience. And all the years of doing this at this level, it's just, you know, I wish everybody in our business that works hard, has a passion for what we do, does it the right way with integrity and character, has an opportunity to experience what we have in our two national championships here in Florida.
Coach, what's the in-season program like for you right now as far as lifting and conditioning and everything?
Yeah, right now what we're doing in season, we work out on Sundays. That's a practice day. We'll train three groups. We train our young developmental guys at 2:30, and then we'll train the offense and defense in two separate groups. And then we go out to practice. And then on Mondays, our day off, NCAA mandatory day off. And then we'll lift again on Wednesday and Thursday for the guys that play. Skill guys will go on Wednesday, and the big guys will go on Thursday. And then on Friday as well, we'll have another developmental lift. Developmental guys will lift Sunday, Wednesday, Friday. And the travel team, or the guys that are getting game reps, will lift on Sunday, Wednesday, or Thursday, two times a week.
A lot of benching, squatting, the whole.
Yeah, we try to get our total body work done on Sundays, and we'll do three or four lower body exercises and three or four upper body exercises with our core as well on Sunday. The guys that play a lot of reps and are a little bit sore and beat up tend to have the load a little bit lower. The guys that maybe aren't getting as many repetitions, we're going to continue to try to get strong and continue our program. Then on the second day is primarily upper body. We'll do a little bit of hip flexor and hamstring work on Wednesday, Thursday, but more than likely we're going to do a bunch of upper body stuff.
Coach, you guys are the number one team in the country right now. Looks like it's going to stay that way for quite a while. What's the conditioning like right now as far as sprints during practice to keep you guys fast? You guys are one of the fastest teams.
Well, right now what we do is we condition basically three times a week on Sunday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays. We do our conditioning before practice, and it's all speed endurance. We don't do a whole lot of long, slow, you know, post-practice gassers or 300s. Everything's short, quick, from 10 to 20, maybe 30 yards. It's all done in a dynamic warm-up, build up to full-speed phase. A lot of our conditioning comes from our practice tempo. We try to get as many repetitions as we can in a 5-minute period in practice.
Game day for you, when the game starts, what does the strength coach for the Florida Gators actually do?
Well, my job is maybe a little bit different than most strength coaches. Obviously, I'm the head backup coach, which we all are, but I've got a staff that kind of takes care of that. My job is to inform the head coach of anybody that has been injured on a particular play. Because he runs our special teams, it's probably not a job that a lot of people want, because there's some remarks back to me by the head coach in the heat of the battle that probably could stay on air right now. Well, right now, Coach Meyer is meeting with recruits that come on an unofficial visit type setup. He's just making sure our players are right, going over some final checks on the offense and defense, and just making sure that everybody's, you know, primed and ready to go here for kickoff at 7:15 tonight.
A little more than an hour and a half before kickoff, Coach. Where is everybody? This is the number one team in the country.
Well, I think our operations people let our fans in, I think, an hour before the game. You'll get a good taste of the atmosphere here on game day when we run out of the tunnel. It's something special. It's, again, one of those experiences that everybody that enjoys college football needs to come down and see.
Coach ASAP, Athletic Strength and Power, wishes extend a big thank you to you, Coach Meyer, and all the Florida Gators for having us down here today.
Well, we appreciate you guys coming down. I've been a great friend for a long time in the business, and hold on to your seatbelt here, because it's going to be a ride.
All right.
Well, we are as well. Hopefully we come out, play hard, play as a team, play with chemistry, and play with a passion.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Ed.
The best was yet to come, as we give you all access.
Good, Jim. Karaoke 20 and back.
We got to reset the ball right over there.
Dropping back, looking to throw, and puts it up. Tebow, rainbow down the field, wide open in quarantine. Yanni Thompson, there goes 6-4-6, touchdown, oh my!
On the end of the day, Coach Ford, man, first he had me on the field, so I was like, Coach, back to money. You know, you still have to cross my heart, you know, like, you know, you got to take care of it. You know, you want to go
back to it. He's got to be
Thank you.
back side side.
Hey, Mick.
Congrats.
Oh, yeah.
I don't do back pedal.
Then I'll go backwards ever.
Let's go.